contact, so when we put the pulp in, it doesn't slide underneath. But you don't want to press down on this hard, because then it stretches out the screen, it's not taut, and it doesn't work well. Okay, so will you hold for me, and just kind of hold it in those places. So, can you see? Yeah. And what you're going to do is we want you to start at least to begin with one color, so that if it messes up, we can put it back in the tub and use it again. Once you get going and figure it out, if you want to do multicolored ones, you can do that. So you're going to take a cup and dip it in. And then this is a pouring technique. So you start pouring it in. You don't want it to be in clumps. So it's kind of like a lot of things. You have to get a feel for it. I mean, you know, someone can talk to you about pressure on a pencil or a brush, but it's using it that, and that was a little too much. Probably because I was talking and not concentrating, and because my hand is not all there. That's a good excuse, isn't it? Anyway, so I basically got them filled up, right? So, did my fingers go in it?
No.
So you don't want to mess with it, because when you start pushing it around with your fingers, then the fibers go like this, so they don't lock and stay together, okay? So if you let go, I will just lift up straight. So you can see we didn't hold down quite as well as we should have right there. So that's something to remember when you're doing it. In each mold and each screen is going to be a little different. But I can gently kind of pull that off, okay? So now we've molded a piece of paper.